Hello everyone, welcome to Accountancy class. I am Divya, lecturer in Commerce, GSI PU College, Mysore. Today in this session, let us learn about 12 marks problem from Chapter 6, Session 8, Accounting for Share Capital if shares are issued at a premium. Let's get started. So here in this question, Vijay Trading Company Limited issued 10,000 equity shares of 10 each at a premium of 2 per share. The amount was payable as follows: rupees 2 on application, rupees 5 on allotment including premium, rupees 3 on first call and rupees 2 on final call. All the shares were subscribed and the money duly received except the final call on 1000 shares. The directors forfeited these shares and reissued them as fully paid at 8 per share past the journal entries. Then first you extract the given information. In this question, issued is 10,000 shares, subscribed also 10,000 shares. There is no oversubscription or undersubscription. Application rupees 2, allotment rupees 5, first call rupees 3, final call rupees 2. When you add 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 2 equals to 12 rupees. Actual value of the share is 10 rupees plus 2 rupees is the premium amount. So it is included in the allotment stage. The premium amount is 2 rupees, means the allotment amount is 3 rupees. On 1000 shares, the company received the application amount, allotment amount as well as first call amount. The company failed to receive the final call amount on 1000 shares. This is called in arrears. So the actual subscribed is 10,000 shares. 1000 shares amount is not received. So the company will receive only on 9000 shares. When the company does not receive the final call amount, the company forfeited those shares, 1000 shares, and it is reissued at 8 rupees. So write the ending journal entries in the books of Vijay Trading Company Limited, date, particulars, ledger folio, debit and credit. So the first journal entry is for receiving the application amount, bank account debited to share application account. So the total number of shares subscribed is 10,000, application amount is 2 rupees. 10,000 into 2 rupees equals to 20,000. Being the application money received on 10,000 shares at rupees 2 per share. This is the narration. Share application account debited to share capital account. So the share application account is credited with 20,000. Now I am debiting with the same amount, 20,000. Next entry, due entry for share allotment. Share allotment account debited to share capital account. So in this question, the shares is issued at a premium. So when the shares is issued at a premium, due entry for allotment is share allotment account debited to share capital account to securities premium account. Number of shares subscribed is 10,000. Share allotment amount is 5 rupees. That is 10,000 into 5 rupees equals to 50,000. So actual share allotment amount is 3. premium amount is 2 rupees. So 10,000 into actual allotment amount is 3 rupees, that is 30,000. Next, security premium account is credited with 10,000 into 2 rupees equals to 20,000. So questionally, actual allotment amount 3 rupees, so a premium amount 2. Hey, gotai nimge questionally allotment jotali including premium anta heli kottidare. So including premium, premium amount questionally specify madidare 2 rupees anta heli. So, allotment amount alli 2 rupees premium amount to include agide anta helidre 5 minus 2 equals to 3 rupees. 3 rupees allotment amount, 2 rupees premium amount. So share capital account is credited with the actual allotment amount and security premium account is credited with rupees 2. That is 10,000 into 2 equals to 20,000. Share capital account is 10,000 into 3 equals to 30,000. So the total allotment amount is actual allotment plus premium equals to 5 rupees, that is 10,000 into 5, 50,000. So write the narration. Being the share allotment money due on 10,000 shares at rupees 5 per share including premium. Next entry, for receiving the allotment amount, bank account debited to share allotment account. So in the third entry, share allotment account is debited with 50,000. Now you credit with the same amount, 50,000. The bank will receive, bank received the allotment amount with including premium. So the narration is, being the allotment money received. Next entry, for the first call money due. Fifth entry, share first call account debited to share capital account. So the total number of shares subscribed is 10,000. The first call amount rupees 3. So 10,000 into 3 equals to 30,000. This is the due entry. The narration is, being the share first call amount due on 10,000 shares at rupees 3 per share. Next one, receiving the first call amount, bank account debited to share first call account. Amount is, here the share first call account is debited with 30,000. Now you are crediting with 30,000. First call stage alli full amount bandide, that's why we are recorded rupees 30,000. So narration is, being the first call amount received. Seventh entry, that is the due entry, for final call amount, share final call account debited to share capital account. So total number of shares subscribed is 10,000. Final call amount 2 rupees, that equals to 10,000 into 2 rupees equals to 20,000. company with the expectation that they're going to receive the full amount, they will pass the due entry, that is share final call account debited to share capital account. Amount bande barate ant heli journal entry anna pass madirtare. So 10,000 into 2, 20,000 being the final call amount due on 10,000 shares at rupees 2 per share. Next one, receiving the final call amount bank account debited to share final call account. In the final call stage, 1000 shares amount is not received. Total subscribed is 10,000 minus call scenarios 1000, then you'll get 9,000. So 10,000 shares amount, full amount receive martilla final call stage alli, 1000 shares amount bartilla. So 10,000 minus 1000 equals to 9,000. The bank received only on 9,000 shares at rupees 2 per share, on that is 18,000. So write the narration, being the final call amount received on 9,000 shares at rupees 2 per share. When the company does not receive the final call amount on 1000 shares, the company forfeited these shares and reissued at rupees 8 per share. So the journal entry is share capital account debited, forfeited shares account to share final call account. Yava stage alli amount bartilla namge, final call stage alli bartilla. Hagadre navu premium na illi ignore martivi. If the shareholders fail to pay the amount in the allotment stage, means then you should debit the security premium account here. In this question, the shareholder failed to pay the amount in the final call stage, so we are not considering the premium amount. Allotment stage alli fail agidre security premium account forfeiture entry pass madvaga illi security premium account debit madbekittu. Adre final call stage alli fail aagtirodrinda illi security premium account anna naavu consider madalla. 1000 shares amount failed to pay the final call amount. So what is the actual value of the final call amount? 2 rupees. Then actual value of the share is 10. After including premium, amount is 12 rupees. So your share capital account is debited with actual share capital amount 1000 into 10 rupees. That is 10,000. Share capital account anna niu debit madwaga, actual value of share capital amount alle debit maadbeku. Actual value of the shares is to 10 rupees. Including premium aadmele alli total value 12 rupees anta heli tagondidivi. So illi debit maadvaga actual share value mele debit maadbeku. So 1000 into 10 equals to 10,000. Final call amount is 2 rupees, that is 1000 shares into 2 rupees equals to 2000. 10,000 minus 2000 equals to 8,000. That is forfeited shares account is credited with 8,000, or application amount 2, actual allotment amount 3, first call amount 3, total 8 rupees. So 1000 into 8 equals to 8,000. Higadru record maadabodu illa ant heldre 10,000 minus 2000 equals to 8,000, being forfeiture of 1000 shares for non payment of the final call amount. Next one, 10th journal entry, for reissue of shares, bank account debited, forfeited shares account debited to share capital account. Bank account This is the reissue entry. The shares are reissued at rupees 8. So the total number of shares forfeited is 1000. So 1000 shares into 8 equals to 8000. So share capital account here debited with 10000. Now you credit with the same amount 10000. 10,000 minus 8,000 equals to 2,000. This is debited to forfeited shares account. Or actual value of the shares 10 rupees itto, reissue maadidu 8 rupees, difference is 2 rupees. 2 into 1,000 share equals to 2,000. Itara adru nivu record maadabodu. So illi forfeited shares account debit ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ 2000 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ 10 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ನ 8 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 2000 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ. 9th ಎಂಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಶೇರ್ ಫರ್ಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಇದು ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್. ಸೊ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಶೇರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೆ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಅದನ್ನ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಶೇರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್. ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ 1000 ಫರ್ಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 8 ಫುಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇಡ್ ಅಪ್. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ, ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫರ್ಫಿಟೆಡ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಈಸ್ ಫರ್ಫಿಟೆಡ್ shares account debited to capital reserve account. So 9th entry alli forfeited shares account 8000 credit maadidivi. 10th entry alli 2000 debit agide. So 8000 minus 2000 equals to 6000. So here being the profit balance in the forfeited shares account transferred to capital reserve account. ಈ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 1000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಬರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಆಗಲಿ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಓದಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಕಲಿಬೇಕು. ಯಾವ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಬರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟು ಬರ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಬರೆಯುವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂತಾನೇ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀರಾ. ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂತಾನೇ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ಯು ಆಲ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.